I think that you need to stay ahead of the trends, authors, and this is a movement, and this is something that is that we are taking very seriously. Well, that was crazy. That video, which I kind of knew would go viral because it's so important and because it's so shareable and because it is just a value to you as a viewer. I didn't expect it to go as hard as it did. It's got like over 150,000 views in just a couple of days, which is more than normal for my like very dormant channel. I don't post as often as I used to, but that's going to change because I kind of announced in a recent vlog that I posted since that video that I am announcing and launching a podcast, which is exciting, and it will be on the YouTube channel as well as on all the major podcast platforms. So Spotify, Amazon Music, Apple Podcasts, of course, and YouTube podcasts. So it's all on this channel and you'll be able to click on the podcast tab and you'll be able to follow me from there. I highly recommend you put notifications on because I haven't quite figured out the best posting schedule for that. So it might be a little hit or miss. I might be experimenting with different days and all that. So the trailer is live now, but when I do launch the podcast, it's going to be launched with a few different episodes already so that you'll be able to binge listen to kind of like a range of different styles of different episode topics. So that being said, we're going to get into another of these Kobo questions that you have. You guys left me a lot of questions, thousands of comments, and I'm here to answer them. So you guys asked for a step-by-step on how to move to a different e-reader. And the easiest way to do that is to simply stop purchasing books. Let me just tell you like the very, 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 very legal way to do this, which is to just stop buying Kindle books, cancel your Kindle Unlimited subscription, move to the Kobo, get the Kobo Plus subscription, which is the same as Kindle Unlimited. The more people that do that, the more authors will start moving their books over. My understanding is Kindle Unlimited is, unsurprisingly, since it's run by Amazon, has a very restrictive policy on exclusivity. And so if you're on Kindle Unlimited, you cannot offer your book on any of these other kind of unlimited reading subscriptions. So Kobo Plus is out of luck. That being said, I have seen books on Kobo Plus that are on Kindle Unlimited, so maybe there's a workaround there, but if you're an author, I strongly encourage you to check the fine print and ensure that you're not being tied into an exclusive contract because readers are jumping ship, and if you want to maintain your readership, I would highly suggest that you move your books over to Kobo Plus and other similar options. I think that you need to stay ahead of the trends, authors, and this is a movement, and this is something that is that we are taking very seriously. This is a PSA to all authors out there. Please explore uploading your books onto Kobo Plus and making them available to Kobo users. Now let's get into what I did to move myself as a long time Kindle reader. These are just some of my most recent Kindles, like the most modern ones from like 2021 and beyond. But I have had a Kindle since the very first Kindle was ever launched. I remember where I was when it came. I remember unboxing it. It had a keyboard on it. It was huge. What they're doing is just putting readers in such a chokehold that I just feel we have no choice but to move on. If you value kind of what reading is all about, which is knowledge and sharing, not piracy. I'm talking about like being able to lend books to a friend and things like that. A couple of corrections to make on that last video, which is that it may be considered illegal to remove the DRM, which is the digital rights management, from the licensed book that you licensed. I'm saying licensed because that's actually what you did. You, unbeknownst to me, and I'm sure millions of other people and the people watching this video, we didn't know, unless you read the fine print, which we should all do, of course, is that if you buy a Kindle book, and you bought it, full price, not even Kindle Unlimited, full price Kindle book, whatever, you didn't buy that book. You don't own the book. It's not yours to do with it what you please. It is licensed to you, essentially meaning you have, for a one-time fee, a license to read that book. And if you violate that license, you can be punished for it in some ways, I'm guessing banned or have the book taken away or God knows what else. I don't know what they can do to you, to be honest with you. I'm sure they can sue you. Who knows? But it's interesting to me that on these Kindle product pages, it says buy now, add to cart, buy this book, read it on Kindle Unlimited for free because you have a subscription, or buy the book outright. Okay, I bought the book. Actually, I didn't buy the book. I licensed the book. And that's what really, really chaps my ass. But here, anyway, I digress. So what do you do when you have now decided that you are going to move to another ecosystem? For the purposes of this video, since this is what I did, I'm going to say Kobo. But it could be anything. I have no relationship with Kobo. I don't even know if they have like an affiliate program or work with influencers. But I bought everything with my hard-earned money, as I do. I've never been sent a Kindle for free. I've never been sent ebooks for free. I have never been sent Kobo stuff for free. So this is all me paying my own money so I can have a completely authentic and transparent approach to this. Here's what you do. You buy the Kobo. While you're waiting for it to arrive, I recommend the Kobo Libre Color. It is the best in my opinion, and it has physical page turn buttons. I was not a physical page turn button kind of person. I have the Oasis. I didn't really see the point, and then I'm just now fully on the page turn. It's like such a better reading experience. This whole like you have to kind of adjust and move your finger, your thumb, or tap to turn a page. It's not intuitive. It's actually not even ergonomic. And the page turn buttons are fantastic because you can leave your finger kind of like gently over the button and just, it's the best. Okay, so that's what you do. While you're waiting for it to arrive, here's what you're gonna do. Up until February 26, you have to do this. Even if you haven't, not ready to purchase a Kobo, even if you're like, I still love Kindle and I'm gonna stay with Kindle, you need to do this in case, just to future-proof yourself against future you who will change your mind. So do this anyway regardless. You're going to go to the Amazon website, and under the Your Account page kind of menu drop down, you're going to find the one that says Your Content. Under Your Content, you will click on eBooks. If you have a Kindle, you should be able to do this. If you've bought eBooks but you don't have a Kindle device registered under your name and your account, you will not have access to this. This is what we've learned since that video that I posted on Monday. And that is, you will need to have a registered Kindle device to be able to do this. If you don't have one, you're not offered the option to download this to USB. Sorry, Charlie, you're out of luck. All those books that you bought without a Kindle, you will not be able to do anything with those. You will not be able to move them to another device. So that's point number one. All right, point number two, here's what you do. You're going to go to more options under those books, and instead of pushing them to your Kindle, you're going to download it and transfer via USB. You are going to have to select your Kindle as the device that it is basically quote unquote registered to. Remember that device, especially like in my case, if you have 26 Kindles, you're going to know which one is which. And then later on, you're going to download this free software, open source software called Calibre or Calibre. We'll call it Calibre for shits and giggles. You're going to download, and you're going to download some plugins, and I'll leave those plugins linked down below. One of them is a plugin that you input your Kindle serial number into, and it will unlock the digital rights management that allows you then to convert the Amazon Kindle format of that book into a non-digital rights protected format of the book that you purchased. So EPUB, whatever. I recommend EPUB. It's the most universally compatible. It's exactly the same as a Kindle, except it's unlocked. It's like taking a phone that you bought from T and they locked the device to you and you've paid it off and you're like, what the shit? This is my device. I want to do with it what I want. I want to take it where I want it to. And you go and you have it unlocked. It's the same principle. The difference is that Amazon never technically allows you to do this. So it is a violation of their terms of service. And could possibly be considered illegal based on the Digital Millennium Copyright Act. I don't know if that's true. Any lawyers, can you please hop in to the comments and let us know what you think about the legality of this? My instinct is to tell me it's not legal in the sense that it's not like you'd go to jail because it's illegal, but it is a violation of terms of a contract, if that makes sense. I could be wrong. It could be breaking actually international laws like the DMCA laws. Maybe you can go to jail. I don't know. Here we are. Come arrest me. I feel like I own the book that I bought and should be able to do with it what I want, similar to a physical copy of a book. I mean, I just think it's ludicrous. Can you imagine if authors were like, I'm publishing this book and selling it in bookstores, but I still retain the ability and the legal might to say to you, you can't remove this from your house and you can't give this to your neighbor to let her have it as a gift, or you can't like let her borrow it, something like that. Now, obviously, don't go pirating books Obviously, it's a lot more manageable since we're not all bookbinders. It's very difficult to make copies of a physical book. It's very apparently easy to copy a digital book. So piracy, I think they're trying to crack down on that. They're going to say it's for piracy. We know it's not for piracy, okay? We know how Amazon acts, okay? But that being said, you should be honorable and you should be respectful of authors and their hard work. It's their life's work, okay? It's their job. So don't go sharing these books once you've unlocked them in that manner. Don't upload them to sites that you download these things illegally. Don't do that, please. That's not right. That's not, you know, we want authorship to be a sustainable business so that authors can continue to devote their time, money, energy, and creativity into creating these wonderful worlds that we get to escape to. And if there's no money in it because they can't get paid for their work because everybody's pirating their work, then you know, that's on us. So please don't do that. But you can purchase books from other websites. And yes, they might have digital rights. Oh, there's a black cat. There might be digital rights associated and attached to those books as well. But my understanding is if you're doing the same thing you're doing with your Kindle books, you probably can do the same thing with Calibre and the DDRM tool plugin. But anyway, that's as much as I'm going to say about that. There are websites that I'll link down below that explain how to do that. But for legal purposes, I'm not going to show you how to do that, okay? And it worked a treat. It didn't take very long. And the longest part was actually just downloading my books from Amazon. So please do that, like, with time to spare, because it will take a while depending on how many books you have. I only had like 200 books on there. I was surprised. I mean, I'm surprised but not surprised. I have way more physical books than I do ebooks, and that might surprise a lot of you because I'm the self-proclaimed Kindle queen. So I don't know about that, like why it's only showing 200 books in my library. It's kind of surprising. But I also have been a very, very long time Kindle Unlimited subscriber. So back when it was like a beta, so it could be because of that. I've read hundreds upon hundreds of books in Kindle Unlimited. So maybe that's why I would probably have a lot more than I do. My camera just literally shut off. It's got a full battery. I don't know what happened. Amazon, are you involved in this? Anyway, so you're going to download the metadata. Then you're going to, it's going to download the titles, the stars, the it's going to properly format, even though like it, you know, in the conversion process, it might've like done something funny to them. It might have a different formatting for the author's name and the ISBN, which is the international kind of book number type thing. It's going to do all that to really standardize the format of your books. And so I highly recommend doing all that. You're going to do that one by one. You're going to download, you're going to choose like the highest resolution cover from Apple Books versus Goodreads. There are plugins for that too. So just check out the plugins tab, download what you install, what you think is important at your own risk, of course, because these plugins are not like signed or, you know, protected in any kind of way. But I'll put down in the description box some of the ones that I did and that I liked. And then you're going to just keep doing that. Convert them, get them ready. You're going to have your whole Calibre library ready to go. Then you buy your Kobo. And it's literally as easy as unboxing the Kobo, doing what you need to do, creating a Kobo account. And then you plug it in using the USB cable that they provide you into your computer, Mac or Windows. And then you highlight the books that you want to from your library. It will like do this thing where it like says, hey, do you want to connect? We detected you've connected your Kobo to a computer, and you hit connect, and then it kind of goes into like a dormant mode where you can, it's now attached to your computer, and it's as simple as either dragging books directly to the Kobo, or like what I do is I use Calibre since they're converted and has all the information and my ratings and all that. You can even connect Calibre to Goodreads and Overdrive, which is great. But what I do is I then highlight all of those books, and then you click the button send to device, and it will just push them right to your Kobo. You're not going to see it right away, because then what you're going to want to do is then eject that device. So you like hit the drop down menu and you hit eject this device, this e-reader or whatever, and you wait until it's confirmed that it has, and then you can unplug it, and you will notice that the Kobo will kind of do this little loading animation where it says it's importing those books. So that's when it's actually like putting them into the catalog, into the database. So it's taken the information, now it's putting it into the device. And just like that, you're ready to go. All of your books are ready to go. If you've worked on them and downloaded the metadata properly, all of your series will be classified as a series, so you'll be able to sort by series like Throne of Glass or ACOTAR or what have you, Game of Thrones, all of those things that may have been like discrete books and not really organized or not like the author's kind of, you know, last name first, first name last, whatever. All of that will be now standardized and organized, and then it tells you like this is a series. It's like perfect. It's like what I wish I could have done in my Kindle, except you had to do it manually in your Kindle with all those collections. You could do collections in Calibre with the ease of doing it in a desktop. So much better. If you're obsessed with organization like I am, this is key. It is the best thing. A matter of fact, if Kindle had a tool like this, I probably would have stuck with Kindle if they would have not done this whole crappy DRM type thing. It's worth noting that most other online booksellers that sell ebooks also digitally rights manage their books. It's just a way to keep you in their ecosystem and a way to protect the authors from piracy, which I think is good. However, what really chaps my ass is that the books are as expensive as they are and you don't technically own them, you're licensing them. That's a very key difference. And I think that if you're gonna be doing that, the prices of books should be a lot less expensive. And they should not say add to cart, buy now, buy this book, purchase this book. The language needs to be updated there. And if you're gonna do something as drastic as change the way after 16 plus years that people can access their books or transfer them to their Kindle device without warning, you need to give people A, more time to do so, or B, you need to say from this point on. I mentioned that in my earlier video and I still think that applies. But anyway, I hope this information was helpful. And if you want a step-by-step of like how I decorate my Kobo, what's on my Kobo, accessories for your Kobo, accessories for any e-readers, even if you're choosing to stay with a Kindle, good on you. That's fine. That's fine with me. I just want you to be aware of have the knowledge to make that educated and informed decision. But if you want more content on what books I have on my Kobo, I would be happy to do so. And yes, if you found this video helpful, please comment, please share this video with a friend who needs more information about how to directly do this, especially with enough time before the deadline, which is February 26, 2025. Make sure you're sharing this with all of your bookish friends, your book club, and keep spreading the message out there because we are definitely making an impact. More people are making videos like since mine was published, and I think that's really important because it's spreading the awareness kind of like a wildfire. So please share this with your other book influencers that you follow and your BookTube friends and Bookstagram and BookTok. I think it's all really, really important. So thanks for watching, and make sure you like, comment, and share this video. Bye.